What?
What? Dad, I'm trying to do this podcast. What's going on? Give me a Pepsi.
You're always ruining everything, Dad.
Hey, it's too loud. I'm trying to sleep. Turn it off.
What?
Come on. We're just trying to do this podcast.
We want to record.
Hey, keep it down.
God. Every time, I'm just trying to do this, man. I just wish you'd give me like a Pepsi or something. And it's like, he just keeps doing this stuff. Too loud? Eat this.
Welcome to the Hardly Heroes Podcast.
High above the city, they shine in my spotlight. Commissioner on the rooftop, double H in the night sky. For the sidekicks we fight, for the right crosses we throw. For the ninjas we injure, revenge on our foes. From crime alleys to radioactive insects, genetic mutations, Weapon X rejects our infinite arson and crisis. Our wars are civil but secret. Here come
Buddy
Dillard Skillard,
Cheese Whiz,
blaring through your speakers. Yeah, Hardly Heroes. It's clobbering time.
Welcome to the Hardly Heroes Podcast, a podcast dedicated to movies, TV, and everything geek-related. I'm your host, Buddy, the Mad King.
What up? I'm Dillard Scalardo, a.k.a. LaDonathon Jenkins.
And I'm Sheila, a.k.a. Tater Tot.
No, cheese.
Cheese Whiz.
Yeah, the crappiest of all cheeses.
The cheeser. So,
Dilly, I don't know if you saw my Instagram post. It was on the story today, but I went over to Buddy's house on Tuesday or Wednesday.
Tuesday.
Was this the one Tuesday? About the missing cheese? Or
yeah,
the
and
block?
I straight up left my block of cheese at his house, and he sent me a picture of it, and I'm like, I'm cheeseless.
You just halved it right off the bat?
What? Have you really been eating my cheese?
Oh, yeah.
Don't
add a little bit of grated cheese.
Are you really did?
Yeah.
That's my block of cheese.
It was delicious.
Was that the sharp cheddar?
Oh, yeah. The sharp Tillamook.
All right. We'll get into that because I got a little bit more of a story about that.
Oh, sorry.
So, hello to all the sidekicks out there. If you're a new listener, go
new listeners.
To hardlyheroes.com and you can find out
we
about
love you.
All
What's
up,
guys? The people we're talking about and all the sayings we might say and all the weird nicknames we have for people.
Inside jokes.
Yeah, glossary. All that stuff. And if you're a new listener, you can email straight from hardlyheroes.com. We'd love to hear from you.
Please, we love to
especially
hear.
You, Nick Cage. We really want to hear from you.
Yeah.
Nick Cage in the house once
Nick
again.
Nick Cage is always in the house. He is our special guest always. And
he reminds us to remember the new listeners.
You know what I want is for one of our listeners to just like take on the, what's it?
No, I don't know.
What,
real quick, though.
No, but real quick. What's it called when like a superhero has their other? Oh, like a secret.
Like the guy in the chair?
So like a secret identity, like where they're Nick Cage. They like write in as Nick Cage.
Oh, that'd be funny.
Do you
like
know what
their
saying?
Own, yeah. Persona.
Yeah, their persona. Thank you.
Last week was the Norwegian takeover show.
Which became the Norwegian Civil War because they really started talking smack to each other.
They're battling it out. Cheat. Yeah. Calm down.
There was also, I don't know if you guys know, but the Boat Times playlist has been trending pretty hard.
It's like,
that's the word.
I think it's like world trending.
It is. It's blowing up.
Right and now. I mean, last episode was phenomenal.
And we have last episode, we have the ever burning question that Buddy always wants to know.
Is it gonna hit?
Did it hit?
Is it a hit-o?
Is it gonna hit?
So we also talked about the Super Run, which is a 5K that Cheese somehow got talked into doing. So we do have a Hardly Heroes team for this Super Run. Now, this is in Sacramento, and Johnny, who, of course, is our best and P1 listener, he tried to sign up, and he said he couldn't do it. It said, like, not available in your country.
No way.
Yeah, but it was super cool that he tried. Thank you, Johnny. But if you do live, I guess, in America...
America.
And you don't live in Sacramento, you can still sign up and run like virtually, they said. I don't really know exactly what
but
that entails.
But they won't let the Norwegian Titan?
No, it won't. And I don't know if it's because like his ankles are broken.
No,
Johnny. Johnny,
that is true. I'm the breaker of ankles.
That was just an easy...
Johnny, they're getting on you, buddy.
That was just an easy burn. But anyway, I just do want to go over a few things. So the run... is November 9th, and if you sign up before October 9th, the registration fee is $24.99. Now, if you go to thesuperrun.com and you just regular register, you just go through all the regular register, you're going to come to a point where it asks you if you want to be, if you want to create a team or be part of an existing team. Now, if you hit the existing team, it'll let you look through. You can find Hardly Heroes.
Bam.
Now, our Hardly Heroes team is private, so you need a password to get in, and the password is Sidekicks.
Ooh, Sidekicks.
There you go.
So,
all space, no caps.
All space, no caps?
Yeah.
And so if you guys have any troubles, you can always email us or message us on any of the...
Yeah, because we'd really love for you guys to come out.
Oh my God, it would be so
us.
Much fun. Even if you're not going to do it, we are going to be fundraising and raising money for Project Wish Upon a Star.
Yes, always.
So even if you don't want to run, you can always donate. You can always sponsor us. You can always give us money while we run, walk, jog the 5K.
Shunk.
Yogging.
Are you getting in on this?
I am getting in.
Yeah,
on
Buddy's
this.
Gonna sign up. Dilly, you need to talk to your girl, see if she's signing up.
It's starting to. I think I might.
Yeah,
it's simmering.
I haven't committed fully yet.
Yeah,
but
you know, it's
we're thinking about Dill, doing some shogging.
Yeah, right.
Dill is very non-committal.
He's very non-committal. Shogging. He wants to make it like last minute. He's just gonna show up day of and register.
You know, you're gonna have to just wait and find out.
But I did want to tell you guys that when you do register, it has you pick your color cape that you want, and they send you, you know how you get the number?
Yeah.
They send you a number and a cape. So it's
that's
pretty
that's
cool.
That's awesome.
Mine's going to be red.
But I'm pretty sure that a lot of the charities are obviously like children and stuff like that. You know, Project Wish Upon a Star is obviously supporting children.
Yeah,
so,
of course.
So it's going to be super fun. I think it's gaining steam. I mean, basically ever since I signed up, people are like, oh, Cheese is doing this?
No, it's like,
you know?
It's a thing.
Yeah, it's like a thing. So the thing is that whenever I check the Hardly Heroes team page.
What were you talking?
Whenever I check the Hardly Heroes team page, it basically says your team is just one. So it's like, can I get some people to sign up?
Can I get some peeps?
They're like, I don't really think that you need a team, okay?
We'll have to
you
jump
are
on
the team.
Them. So, they're all somebody from Norway tried to jump.
Exactly. So thank
his
you so
ankles
much,
are broken.
Johnny, you were so sweet to try to sign up. But everyone here in Sacramento, please sign up. Everyone here in America, sign up.
Yeah.
Get it on. Or just give us some money. We take Venmo.
Venmo's. How was everybody's weekend?
You know, what did
it
I even
good.
Do? I worked on Saturday. So.
Yeah, it was a busy one for the Scalardo.
Was it? What'd you do?
I went to the Tahoe's.
Ooh, Tahoe, California.
Really? I haven't heard of the Hose of Tahoe.
Yeah, the Hose of Tahoe.
We're up at the wifey and I were up at the Ridge.
Nice.
Doing some hanging out. We hit the casinos a little bit. Had some oysters at the Hard Rock.
Are you up or down?
On the money?
Yeah.
I'm down.
Out.
Not much, though.
Oh, nice.
That's good.
Not much at all.
I know. Mm. I always give myself just like a really small limit because I don't.
I do.
I lose
$20.
It all. Yeah.
If I lose $20, I'm like,
you got to go in at least with a hundo.
No.
A hundo?
No,
yeah, come on. $20.
No. Crazy.
How am I going to lose
$100? That does nothing for you.
No,
yeah, but you need to have a little bit of leverage. That's the thing. It depends on what you're playing. If we're talking poker or blackjack.
What I like to
penny
do
slots.
Is,
oh, okay, well,
no,
different.
What I like to do is sit at the bar. This is what Logan and I do. We sit at the bar and play video poker.
Yeah.
So
fun.
We
get
free
drinks. Free
drinks.
Sure.
Just fed to us.
The
and
watered
we can,
down drinks.
The watered down drinks. And we can just
no,
play for hours.
No, that's why you go with beer.
You can do that.
That's true. Logan does beer a lot, but I do the mixed drinks because I'm not trying to get sloshed.
So back to Tuesday, me and my sister over here, Cheese Whiz, watched the new Bill Burr special.
Yeah.
Good times?
Quite.
It was really funny. Do you like Bill Burr?
Yeah.
So Bill Burr is mine and Buddy's favorite comedian. And so the thing is that when Bill Burr has a new special drop, we're not allowed to watch it without each other.
No.
So basically...
It's Bill Burr Day.
So yeah. So it's Bill Burr Day. Put it in the calendar.
Bill Burr? Is it Bilber or do you,
Bill Burr
is, it,
Day.
Is there a space in between there?
No, there's no space. It's Bilber. No.
Bilber.
It's Billiam.
It's Bilber Day.
Dearest Billiam.
So Bill Burr has a podcast actually called the Monday Morning Podcast.
Can I tell a funny story about the first Bill Burr Day ever?
Yeah.
So the first
for the feast.
The feast.
That is the first Bill Burr Day.
My me and my wife were only dating at the time, and me and my wife were our families are super close, so we were hiding us dating.
So we've known Michelle since she was like, I think, six
or seven.
Yeah.
Sure.
So I've known her since I was five. So we weren't trying to tell our family, and I'm
That's
she
weird,
spent
man.
The night, a little right? awkward. And then Sheila's like, "It's Bill Burr Day. I'm on my way over." And I'm like, "Oh no." And I totally forgot. So I grab all Michelle's stuff. I rush her out of the house. I jam her down to her house. I drop her off and then just jet back to my house. Like I drive back there as fast as I can. And then Sheila shows up and she's like, "Where were you?" I was like, "Oh, nowhere." Blah, blah, blah. Michelle's texting me. She's like, "I'm locked out of my apartment." She's all, "I don't have my keys. I have to call the landlord to come unlock the door."
And Buddy couldn't go rescue her because I'm over there like, "It's Bill Burr Day."
Right.
It was quite bad. She was quite upset about it. She still brings it up. So she has a little bit of hatred towards Bill Burr.
So also on Bill Burr Day, and this is a shout out to my sweet, wonderful Grammy who just passed away last week on Thursday. She used to always make us this like Mormon meal called Stacky Uppies.
Stacky Uppies.
Ooh, what is that?
It's kind of like a...
Let me guess
okay,
first.
Okay, go ahead.
Stacky Uppies.
Stacky Uppies.
So, I mean, pancakes stack pretty good, right?
Yeah.
There's some waffles, maybe some bacon in there a little bit. I'm thinking breakfast, though.
No. There's no breakfast. It's like a dinner.
Okay. What is a stacky?
So stacky would be.
So
wait.
You got to start at the like. So what it all is you got like.
No, you're explaining.
This sounds like a Scooby Doo's like sandwich, right?
Because look, you get all the fixings of like maybe if you're gonna make a taco salad, like Grandma used to always put them in different bowls. So she'd have a bowl of like tomatoes, a bowl of cheese, a bowl of beans, a bowl of like sour cream, ground turkey or ground beef,
green onions,
olives,
diced olives.
This sounded like some 7-layer dip.
Yeah, so really kind of the makings of a 7-layer dip or a taco
salad or
nachos, right?
Yeah.
So they're all in separate bowls, but the secret grandma ingredient is Fritos.
Yes. Ooh.
So Fritos is the base layer.
Oh, no, she didn't.
So Fritos, refried beans,
that sounds hella good.
Avocado, sour cream,
tomato, cheese,
diced olives, and chee.
And then you
want to get a little crazy, you put a little bit of spicy,
some hot taco sauce, and then you basically just eat it like you scoop
the
fixins with the Fritos.
Yeah,
that sounds delicious.
But what's funny is like as the like our life has progressed, we now get Frito scoops, which is a great invention
money.
For stacky uppies.
Money.
Because you used to have to use those little Fritos.
Oh, it was terrible. Now that you've upgraded to the real big scoops, it's the best.
So every time we watch Bill Burr, we have stacky uppies.
Yeah, it's tradish.
It's tradish.
If you do make some stacky uppies, make sure you tag Hardly Heroes.
Exactly. And so shout out also to my mom. She came to Bill Burr Day and had some stacky uppies with us. So
yeah,
it was a fun time.
Quite fun. So Shmee left her cheese there. So I've been eating.
I brought like just a block of cheese, which I never should have done. I should have pre-grated.
Oh, definitely should have pre-grated.
Because this is the thing is I hate when I show up, like I'll show up at Mammy's or something and someone has that bag of pre-shredded cheese with the powder on it. That's disgusting.
No, so are you ready for this?
Do you guys just travel with like blocks of cheese?
Well, if I think I'm going to show up somewhere with that powdered shredded cheese, I will bring my own cheese.
So Michelle gets some. All right, I never really said it, but I don't like powdered cheese very much. And Michelle, we used to just buy it, and I was like, whatever, it's not that big of a deal. Sheila came over once and made a huge fuss
what's the powdered cheese?
No,
the pre-grated cheese.
The pre-grated cheese.
Why do we call it powdered cheese?
Because they coat it with this powder so it doesn't stick together.
And it never melts.
So it's not.
I kind of know what you're saying because there is a little bit of like.
It has that powder.
It's got that
powder. It's disgusting. Okay. And I cannot stand it because it's really meant to make it keep. It's like probably a preservative type thing. So it's
because once
cheese,
you start cutting it, you know, the oxygen starts.
So the cheese is never the same. You cannot buy pre-shredded cheese. It's disgusting.
Nope.
So I left. So she made this huge fuss about it, and now she never buys grated cheese anymore. But she buys the block of where it's like white and.
Oh, yeah. It's like the Colby Jack.
Yeah. It's like the mix. But Sheila only likes the yellow.
Sharp yellow cheese.
The sharp cheddar.
Yeah.
The sharp cheddar cheese.
You know who does it right is the Wisconsin sharp cheddar.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you know what? You're right. That is very good.
They don't play around with their cheese out there.
Wisconsin.
You
get
some curds.
Mm-hmm. Which we never got.
Yeah, we never got the curds.
Sorry, guys.
she did get a little nice cheese keychain.
This is true.
Next we need to get when she goes back is the cheese head.
Right.
Well, next time I'll be going back.
Or like the cheese stand-in for the photo shoot.
Yeah. No, I wanted to get a little cheese head hat. It'd okay. be perfect.
Yeah.
We're going to hit Chi-Town and
like,
Wisconsin.
Don't they wear that at the
now, how do you feel
the
about,
Packers games?
Yeah.
The cheese head?
The cheese heads.
How do you feel about Packers goat fans. Cheese?
I love goat cheese.
I'm in on goat cheese. I'm firm.
Oh, I'm yeah. super firm on
I
the
I could do it on
yes.
like a salad or something like that.
No,
or
you
maybe
eat
some
it by
crackers.
Itself.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, but.
But it's not my. I wouldn't.
Oh.
I really like an aged Gouda. If
I
you
love
will.
An Ooh. Aged Gouda. I really like hard cheeses. You know, is it the aged Gouda that sometimes has those little crystals in it?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
So good.
It's delicious.
Blue cheese?
Blue cheese, great. Yes.
Oh,
all
see,
day.
That's where I draw the line. What? No, blue chunks is more like it. No. Can't
I
be
love
the blue
cheese.
What do they call it? Roquefort?
Well, what's Mm-mm. funny when you look at the blue cheese, I mean, there's the actual, the mold is in there.
Yep.
It's just funny. It's and so you're like, I'll
straight
do
up
want
moldy
it.
Cheese.
It's so good. Blue cheese is one of my favorites. Feta, good.
Nah, yeah, feta's the
best. I'm not sure good. I found a cheese I don't like.
What about Parmesan cheese? Mm,
is it like.
Like.
Is it like a Parm. Parm alarm, Parm alarm. Everybody get ready. It's the Parm alarm. So I just want to, I don't know if we've officially announced this. I kind of want to give a shout out, but like Logan has basically been promoted to executive producer and James Navarro has come on as our producer.
Yes. Yeah.
So he does so much work for the show. He gets our packets together every week. He is constantly emailing people and sending out texts to us. He texts us a lot. He does so much work and you know, none of us get paid. We just do it cause we love it.
Mm-hmm.
And Parm just came on, just steamed up and
steamed
ready to
like steamy.
He steamed the booth.
He
I mean,
straight
he really
up
did.
Steamed
he got us,
it up.
He got everybody fired up.
Right. So he's come on and he's just done so much. So really,
shout out to the Parm.
Shout out to the Parm. Logan, of course, still is our executive producer and does a lot, but Parm has really stepped up into that position.
Yeah, it's quite nice. So
it's really nice because I was actually telling Buddy, I feel like a lot of times we just kind of show up and we're like, what are we doing? And James has done all the work.
I'm the on-air talent. Yeah. Don't know if you guys know that yet.
The on-air talent.
He's the, what is it?
Oh, he's what? The like radio.
Radio iconic
sensation. Pop.
Which, if you
the
come
pop culture radio sensation.
There we
icon.
Go.
No, you included
I'm
icon.
An icon. do we have an update on the Maui costume?
Honestly, I don't have much of an update because I haven't gotten anything for the costumes yet.
So does anybody have an outfit yet? Like, you guys got to get this together pretty quick. It's coming up.
Really what we need is like a family.
You don't want to throw this together last minute.
No, God. And I would never, Dilly. Okay, I need you to know one thing about me. Okay, this is one thing. I take Halloween insanely serious, and this is how serious I take it, okay? Let me tell you.
Okay.
So Logan, I was saying like, oh, you kind of need a haircut. And he was like, oh, well, Tom Ace kind of has longer hair, so I think that I should grow it out a little bit. I'm like, okay, yeah, that's a good idea.
Good call.
And so if anybody knows me, I love beards on men, and Logan has a beautiful beard, okay? And so Logan mentioned to me, he said, you know, Tom Ace doesn't have a beard. And I'm like, honestly, I respect Halloween so much that I'm willing to let you be clean shaven for a night. I'm going to do it. I'm going to let the beard go.
I'm so excited for this.
That's going to be
fun. But we got to start working now. I got to go buy my pants and my shirt. The only thing I need to find is the HDS.
So I need to. I want to reach out to Shotzi, Mama Groot, a.k.a. Hildy June. And maybe saying it on the show, if she listens to the show, maybe I can just plant this seed, but we need, basically a patch made
of HDS. We need two. We need one on the hat,
one on the breast.
Yeah.
So, Shotzi, if you are listening to this, I'll send you some pictures and see if that's something you can do. Cause I wonder if we can just bring it into some kind of embroidery place. Do they have that?
Yeah, I mean, we could probably find anybody in the sidekicks.
Can't you go to those like hat stores and they'll embroider stuff on it?
Maybe.
On hats? I don't know.
But not on the shirt?
I don't know.
But maybe they can make a patch? I don't know. I'll ask Shotzi. She probably knows more about it than I do.
I know the sidekicks want to know, did Shmee go see It?
No.
Dill skill?
Because I'll tell you why I didn't see it is because no one was forcing me to do it. Dilly.
Dilly.
You didn't like it? Oh, you're doing that to me.
I didn't see it.
Oh.
I tried to see it.
So, Buddy, can you talk about it?
But I've seen it.
It didn't work out.
Can Buddy talk about it or no?
Sure. Please.
Is that going
to
spoil?
Because I've kind of checked out some reviews.
Okay.
I try to keep an open mind. I'm gonna see it.
So, I laughed. So, Friday night, Michelle and I were hanging out with Alex, my buddy Alex, and shout out to Blanny was in the house.
Blanny?
Yeah, Blanny was in the house. We were chatting it up.
What's up, Blanny?
Blanny the male Manny.
And if anybody doesn't know, Blanny, a.k.a. Manny, used to be a host on the show, and now he has a new podcast called In Podticular, so go check it out.
Yeah, so we're hanging out, and we started talking, and he was like, oh, are you going to go see It? And Michelle, like, lit up. So we bought tickets Friday at, like, 12:30 in the morning to make sure we would go to Saturday, so... Went to Saturday at like 12 in the afternoon.
At XD?
Yeah, Michelle was steamed up. Yeah, where we had our movie event, Theater One. She's all steamed up. She really liked the first one. So we go in there and we're sitting down, got a popcorn, got a snacky snack.
Do you have a Coke Icy?
Pop.
What?
What happened? No Coke Icy.
They were out?
It wasn't working.
Oh my God. I would have
walked
out. You know
things aren't going to be.
I was very upset.
I would have walked out. I mean, like, what?
I didn't even already have my tick.
You should have said, make it work.
Yeah. You need to freeze some Coke right now.
Hand make that.
So, yeah, we started watching the movie. And about halfway in, Michelle's like, can we leave?
What?
I think I've come to the realization that it just doesn't work when you have adults afraid of a clown. It just doesn't work. It makes sense when you're a kid and you don't really know what's going on, but you have this hard time believing in these adults that all this stuff's going down.
But it's not like they're just afraid of the clown. It's a killer clown. It's like they're afraid of a murderer.
Yeah,
right,
but
that,
there's
that
parts where they're
their
like
childhood.
Yeah, but they're like, it's not real, it's not real, it's not real. And then like parts, you know, like,
is it real?
Oh, it's real.
It's real. But it's just, and they flash back to the kids and you're like, oh my gosh, this is why I like it. And then they go back to the adults and you're like, I just felt like it didn't hit, and you're constantly flashing back and you're like, oh, the kids, this is where it's good. Where I feel if they did it where it constantly was going back and forth the whole time, it wouldn't be as bad. But the first movie was so good because you didn't have the adults. Mm-hmm. Where this, it's heavy on the adults and sprinkled in the kids.
Oh, what have you read?
Spranks.
Dilly, what's the reviews looking like for it?
Yeah, it was pretty much, it's like a non. Yeah, people are not as excited as the first one. It definitely,
well, you know, that's what the old movie was like too, though.
And that's why I said it is everybody's it's like, always, it's going to be better this time. And I just
that's
didn't.
Really not.
But I see what you're saying, though. Like,
and kinda, there was one
just
part.
Hard to buy into it.
There was one part that was really freaking weird. And you're just like, okay, this is, I don't know. It's just not what I expected. And it's hard because I really love the original and I always stand up for the original, but it's just second you get adults, it just doesn't work as well.
That's sad to hear.
And the guy that plays Ben, I don't know why, he just looks weird to me.
Do you know the actor?
I can't remember his name off the top of my head, but he looks a little weird.
Oh, okay.
But it, overall...
So what do you give it out of a 10?
Yeah.
On a scale of 1 to it.
Maybe a 4.
Really?
Oh, damn, that bad?
Dude, I told Michelle the main reason why we had to stay is because...
You have to...
Yeah, and she looked at me at least 4 times and was like, I'll leave if you want. And I'm like, no. I'm like, it just reminds me of X-Men. I'm like, you just got to power through till the end.
And I honestly, it takes a lot for me to walk out of a movie. I'm just like, no, I'm just going to invest. I want to see where it goes. But also with it, I mean, you kind of have to stay and see it. It's like, what, are you just going to see half the movie and then never see the rest? I mean, come on.
Right. I mean, isn't
it
3 hours long?
His name is Jay Ryan.
Oh, I don't know who that is. But so, Buddy, the clown, Pennywise in this movie, was he scary?
Yeah, it's just she didn't get a lot of him. Or, I mean, at least I felt like the first one was way creepier. And, like, the whole scene in the apartment that they show, Beverly's apartment.
Yeah, with the grandma.
I wish they would have not shown any of that at all, because that was probably the best, like, clown part, where I was just like, oh, okay. Snap.
Yeah.
But because it felt so much more creepier than the original, that you're just like, okay, this is... And the sewer part was pretty cool, but just overall, I was kind of like, eh.
So, does anybody get, like, sucked through the tube like they did on the in the original?
Oh, remember sucked through the drain?
Yeah. Well, not the drain, but there was a scene, I thought it was in the second chapter.
Oh.
Where the kid gets, like, sucked backwards and he gets pulled through the pipe in the sewer.
They no, but that? I will give it up. The guy that plays the kid that cuts Ben, can't remember that character's name. You know what I'm talking about? The one that goes to the mental ward?
Yeah.
Dude.
Bravo.
That guy played that part amazing. He was my favorite guy of the adults. You were just like, dude, this guy legit is like creepy as like creepy as hell.
Would you say it was a phenomenal performance?
It was fantastic.
Did his performance hit?
It definitely hit hard.
So,
if
really...
You, if I could give it a
I
fan,
wonder if I...
I can't say it.
Would you give it a...
Fantas?
Oh, yeah. Definitely a shitting.
So, do you think I could watch the second one because it, since you thought it was bad, it's not as scary?
Yes. Okay. As the first one.
Yes. Real quick, if we're done talking about it, I have something I want to...
Go ahead.
Yeah.
So, this is just a... actually, a shout out to HTC because I actually have a gift for you guys.
What? HTC Sizzle.
Channeling your
So it's
inner
not comic
HTC?
Books. It's not comic books, but.
Is it a snack, perhaps?
It's not a snack because Dad does not like when you freaking eat on.
I love
What's happening right now?
On air.
You have presents for us?
Yeah, I have presents.
We like that.
So it
Did
is
you
crinkly.
Do these?
No, I bought these.
What is this?
Oh my gosh, I've never been more excited than I am right now.
It's
mine is a magnet of Larry David's head,
and mine is of my number one fave actor, Sac State alumni Tom Hanks,
the number one fan in the house.
So just a shout out, this is a Etsy shop called Mothership, and she makes these magnets that are just heads of like actors and stuff. And so I had a friend who got me the magnet of Nick Cage's head, and it's on my refrigerator, and I have pictures of me and Logan has a like a family picture of him and his, you know, dad and mom. So I'll put Nick Cage's head like on Buddy's head or Logan's dad's head, right? So I went and looked at her shop on Etsy, Mothership, and she has tons of them. So I got one for myself as well. Okay.
Is it cheese?
No, I got Keanu.
Ooh, Keanu.
Keanu Reeves.
Keanu.
Keanu Reeves' head. So, well, I'll take a picture of these and post it.
I love it.
But
you got
the shop
me LD.
Is great. I actually got one for a friend's kid, but I don't want to say it on, just in case he listens to this, because I want to send it via email.
Via email.
I mean, via...
Via
the post, the post mail.
What are you doing?
You're gonna send it through the dark web.
I don't know. Sometimes I get nervous, and
she's like clenching her shirt.
Okay,
it's like superstar.
So anyway, I just wanted to give you guys those gifts. I saw.
Thank you.
Really,
yeah.
What?
Thank you,
really, what happened, buddy? Really cool. Is I saw that Tom Hanks one, and I'm like, I have to get that for Dilly.
Yeah.
And then I was like, oh, LD, Larry David.
Gotta love LD.
I have just the outfit to wear this with. Wear this with, so happens.
What are you gonna? It's a magnet, though.
I'm gonna, yeah. You're I gonna, have chest
that's
plate.
A good one.
Oh, do you? It'll stick
chest.
To you?
Yep.
It's kind of like, it's like young Tom Hanks, too.
Oh, yeah.
It is.
Goody.
It's almost like Turner and Hooch, maybe.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
No, well, he doesn't
For
have
sure.
the.
Maybe big.
Yeah,
this
maybe
could be
big. Because yeah, Turner and Hooch, he has more of like a mullet.
Bob mullet.
So, anyway, moving on. Should we get into our correspondent?
Yeah.
Should we listen to the news?
Live from the inside of a glass of scotch neat on the Las Vegas Strip, it's the Correspondent with Phil Burgundy. Are we live? We're not live. Who's in charge here?
So swanky.
Where's my music cue? Who took my scotch? It's okay. I found my scotch. Crisis averted. Now we can do the news.
How now, brown cow? How now, brown cow? How now, brown cow?
Apple revealed all kinds of goodness from Apple TV Plus and all the cool shows starring friend of the show Jason Momoa to Apple Arcade, which features new original content with no in-app purchases or ads for only $5 a month. Between Apple and Disney, just take all of my money. I don't need it anyways.
Shut up and take my money!
Speaking of Disney, Sony CEO Tony Vinciquerra made a statement saying the Spider-Man deal is dead for the moment. So seeing Pete lead the Young Avengers probably won't happen now because Sony.
You suck!
Well, Sony sucks. And is here to ruin our comic book nerdy dreams. Excuse me while I go throw a hissy fit.
No! No! No!
No!
Now that's better. Hashtag let my Spidey go. Now, your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to figure out how Tom Cruise hasn't aged since 1983. Is he a vampire? Is he proof that Scientology works? Does he drink celery juice? This tape will self-destruct in 3, 2, and 1. Two more Mission Impossible films are being made, and they're bringing in Hayley Atwell, aka the other Peggy I dream about on a nightly basis. DC leaked a rumor for the basic plot synopsis for The Batman, and it seems like a noir detective film, which really is everything the Batman franchise has been missing. It will show off multiple characters from Batman's rogues gallery to include the Riddler, Catwoman, Penguin, and a never-before-seen character on screen, Firefly, which will be pretty cool, especially if he gets the full jetpack and long-range flamethrowers like he has in the comics.
Cool story, bro.
And last, staying in the realm of Warner Brothers, Dr. Sleep's new trailer was all of The Shining Revisited we want it to be. With Obi-Wan Kenobi in the lead role as Danny, he nails the vibe of creepy kid from the Overlook Hotel.
Here's Johnny!
This is also a movie we will have to force Squeeze Cheese McWhiz over here to watch alone in the dark with no parental supervision.
I need an adult.
Well, that's it from this sector of the galaxy. Let's keep the conversation moving in the Hardly Hero Sidekick Sanctorum, and tune in next week where we try to unravel life's greatest mystery, the one thing we do not understand, no matter all the research we do and all the work we put into it. Will it hit?
Oh, man. Philippe is great. That was a really... That beginning part...
Dude... I feel like every time I'm like, man, it can't get any better. That was phenomenal.
That was so good.
That might have been my favorite one thus far.
Yeah, that was one of my favorites, and definitely the end part about is it going to hit?
Is it going to hit?
It's a hitter.
So let's go over some of the stuff you talked about. So
Apple TV Plus?
Apple TV announced it's $4.99 a month.
Okay. Yet another streaming service.
Yet another streaming.
We're getting more than cable now, I feel like.
And that's the thing. It's like if you add it all up, we're up to cable prices.
Oh, definitely.
I kind of want to do like a little calculator right now.
Right, so. like add it up because what?
$4.99 for Apple, and then how much?
$6.99 for Disney.
Okay.
I would say $15 for Netflix. Does anybody pay?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Another probably $15 for Hulu if you get no ads.
Don't forget Sheboygan Amazon TV. But
what's Amazon like a month? Because
it's part of the you pay like $100 for Amazon Prime, and it's part of the deal
for a year.
So just tack on another hundo.
Well, no, but we're doing per month.
So the year. So that's
so do like $8 or something a month.
Okay.
Do $15 for HBO.
I forgot about them.
And then is there any other?
Does ESPN Plus? You got to have that.
Well, that's in...
That's going to be Disney Plus.
That's going to be wrapped up in there. All
right. So what is that total right now?
What about your ABC?
Or no, CBS?
Yeah.
So I think that's another 10 if you don't want ads.
So that's $74.98 right there.
And then what if somebody has the DC?
Oh, the DC.
You got to have that.
Do people have that?
Yeah, I think it's $12 a month.
Yeah, so tack on the new Apple Arcade. I mean, that's not really streaming, but just another subscription.
Right. Yeah, so it's almost $90 a month.
For all the subscriptions. And that's,
but you got to have internet, too.
Exactly.
So you're about what cable is.
Yeah, $179 now.
Yeah, with cable, I mean, or with internet, Wi-Fi.
Mm-hmm. That fiber optic.
Yeah.
Gotta have that whiffy.
You gotta have the whiffy. It's
gotta have the goods, too.
Honestly, it's crazy. It's getting crazy. I mean, something has gotta give, right? We can't... I'm not paying...
Look at how long you paid for.
And the funny thing
for.
is this is just the beginning.
I know. Like,
there's going to be so many of these streamings.
So much more.
Everybody's going to have one.
Well, really kind of with the way we do it, and I feel like a lot of people do this, is we just share it. So like Logan's brother pays one.
Shh.
What? You're allowed to do that.
Don't say it out loud.
Yeah, you're allowed to.
I don't say that.
You're allowed to share, to have different devices.
Yes, but you're not supposed to share it amongst a family.
Oh, you're not supposed to do that?
No.
Oh, we do that all the time.
That is a no-no.
I don't think AT&T is listening to our podcast.
You never know. I know. Are you going to watch The Morning Show on Apple Plus?
I am absolutely going to watch The Morning Show on Apple Plus. So The Morning Show is a cutthroat drama starring an executive producer by Reese Witherspoon and Jennifer Aniston. So starring... And they're producing. Okay, perfect. And it's starring Steve Carell. So I'm into it. It explores the world of morning news and the ego, ambition, and the misguided search for power behind the people who helped America wake up in the morning.
Wake up, wake up, wake up.
So I'm into that because, one, morning shows are stupid. I don't watch them. But also, I love Jennifer Aniston and I love Steve Carell. And actually, more probably because of Big Little Lies, love Reese Witherspoon.
She was good in that. Did we talk about C
I
yet?
I guess because no. Since you get it for free, if you buy an Apple device, it will do pretty good.
Oh, right. Did we mention that? Did he say that in his news? So the promo is it's you get 1 year free of Apple TV Plus if you purchase an Apple device.
Yeah. So
that should work out because I'm actually in the market for another Apple TV.
And that's the thing, too, is
an Apple TV or an Apple phone?
Both.
Oh,
everything
snap.
Apple.
Snap.
Everything.
Yeah. So the thing with Apple TVs, you guys, though, seriously, this is the root of their model, okay? An Apple TV costs upwards of $200.
Yeah.
And a Amazon Fire Stick that literally does the exact same thing is $40.
But does the Amazon Fire Stick have all your Apple stuff on it?
No, that's true. But that is the point. Like, that's the thing what Apple does is, like, it literally, you can't integrate with anything else. You have to have everything Apple.
Do,
and then they jack up the price of it. And you're fine with that?
That's just how it goes. I've been on board. So just got to keep it moving.
I get what he's saying.
No, well, I get. No, but the thing is because I know that they do that, I can't buy into it. It drives me crazy. I can't believe that people are just like, oh, yeah, sure.
I see what you're saying. I mean, it's like it does the same thing, but
the technology
but
see,
you
is
get to have all your content.
I know,
that you've
but the thing is like
time.
You can make it all work together. They can do that, but they don't because they want you to pay $200 for an Apple
but
TV.
But at the same
that
time,
that doesn't anger you?
What do you need it for? You have a smart TV now.
Well, no, that's true.
I don't even use mine
right,
because
the
have
TVs
a,
come with streaming.
Yeah,
I
have everything on my smart TV.
Well, you know what? I don't have a smart TV, brother. I can't afford to buy a new TV, so I have to use my
They're
Amazon
like 200
Fire
bucks.
Stick. My Fire Stick.
You have six TVs in your house.
I do not.
You have one in the kitchen.
Yeah, that's little, and that was not a smart TV.
You know how much you could buy a small 36-inch TV for now? $200.
$100.
A smart TV.
Probably even cheaper than
yeah,
that.
Yeah, probably about $100. You can buy a 50-inch TV for $300.
Yeah, but is the quality of it going to be good?
Be okay.
Because the thing is like this TV that we have in the studio is a little cheaper, and it's like you can tell when you watch high quality stuff, it's like, it doesn't look that
high
good.
High quality H2O.
Yeah, it doesn't show up the good on the screen. Anyway, so moving on, we've got Apple Arcade, which will launch next week and
Are
costs $5.
That?
That sounds kind of fun. I mean, it's all exclusives, all new stuff, right? It sounds like.
Well, no, they have
I might
Pac-Man.
Give it a shot. Well, it's a Pac-Man Battle Royale, Party Royale.
Oh, so it's new installments
it's
in the
it's
classic
100
franchise.
Exclusive games. So we'll see. I don't think it's going to be like classic games.
Well, it
those
says it's a new installment in the classic franchise featuring a 4-player battle mode. So it is different.
Right.
So they're just taking classic stuff and making it new.
Sure. I might give it a shot. I'll do the free trial. See where it takes me.
I'm out.
But it also says that games will have no ads or in-app purchases and won't be available anywhere else.
That is nice.
So again, Apple being freaking Apple, right? You probably have to have an Apple phone to have the Apple Arcade.
Oh, definitely.
For sure. So if there's some game that everybody's playing and
you don't
have an
Apple
phone.
And guess what?
You
can play that on your Apple TV, too.
And if you don't have an Apple phone, then you can't be part of the party.
You got
to
be down.
Yeah, but at the same time, you have to pay that $5 to play it. So I doubt a lot of people are going to do that.
It's $5 a month.
Yeah, people are a little bit cheapskates.
And real quick, I'm going to take a little page out of your book.
Yeah, there you go.
Shout out to Goat, because I know he's super fired up right now because Borderlands 3 comes out tonight in like a half hour.
Are you getting it?
I don't know if I'm going to pick it up at launch. I'll probably wait a little bit, but I know he's been playing it. He's been waiting for that. And it's a big game. It's a big release. If you have it preloaded, it comes out tonight at 9. If not, you can pick it up tomorrow or whatever.
On that launch.
Yep.
So to the preload, you had to have signed up already?
You have to pre-order the game, and then you kind of pre-download it. And as soon as they release it,
it's already
you can play it.
You can start playing.
Yeah.
I don't know how it all works, but that sounds pretty cool. So Goat's going to be playing that tonight.
Spider-Man, the Sony CEO says the door is shut.
What's funny, though, is it says...
It's a wrap.
For this moment, the door is closed, so... That means it's not over.
The door could always reopen.
But also it's like, right? Over it. Well, just do it or don't do it. Just shut up about it anyway.
Everybody's mad about it. I've been getting a lot of chit talk.
Yeah, and there's definitely been a lot of action on the Sanctorum about it. Constant updates about the Spider-Man. And, you know, I know it's important to all of us.
It's a big deal.
It's a huge deal, and it's really important, but... What I just want everyone to understand, the root of this, it's the same thing with Apple. It's all about money and they don't care about you.
Is it a hit?
Moving on. Corporate America. So Mission Impossible. Do we need any more Mission Impossibles?
No. Shout out to my boy Aaron Watson.
What?
He is a huge...
What?
Tom...
What? What?
He's a Tom Cruise... fanatic.
Wait, what is that? Is that from something?
What? Yeah, it's Dave Chappelle.
Oh, that's right. Is it when he's doing the...
What?
Actually, just real quick, this is totally off topic. Have you guys seen his new stand-up, Dave Chappelle?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
So good.
Woo! A little controversial.
Oh, for sure. All of his stuff is controversial.
Oh, yeah.
But he's so good. I think he's a genius.
Was that supposed to be Little John or
something? Oh, yeah, Little John.
What?
He says that. Yeah. Oh. No, I'm sorry. I'm bad at impressions.
That was terrible.
I'm going to cut that out.
Negative.
I can edit.
Negative Ghost Rider, the pattern is full.
Okay, so Mission Impossible.
Bringing it back to Top Gun.
Moving on. We don't need any more Mission Impossibles. Although I actually do... Like Tom Cruise a little bit. And I like
they're
Mission
decent movies. You
I
know,
like
it,
Mission Impossible.
You can Netflix it or something. It's a decent watch.
And the thing is, I don't want to ever compare Tom Cruise to Keanu, but he's kind of that. He's getting older, but he can still do it. He can still kick and fight and everything.
Who would you prefer, Keanu?
Keanu. You don't even have to ask the question.
I'll take Keanu.
Keanu, 100%.
Yeah. On the whole body of work?
Excellent.
Or as of right now.
Oh. I mean, no. Tom Cruise probably has a better library.
Library?
Yeah.
A catalog.
Thank you. That was the word I was looking for. He probably has a better catalog. But Keanu, the thing is that he's
Keanu.
Just...
Come
Keanu.
On, do
is
it,
just
Dilly.
So legit.
Johnny Utah?
He's so legit.
Oh, I do love Johnny Utah. Yeah. Utah, give me two.
Booty.
So then the plot for the Batman movie. Can I tell you guys something? I'm over Batman. These Batmans ever
I'm
since
with you on that. I just don't care about anymore.
Yeah,
about
like
Batman.
Ever since Christian Bale, like these bat like having what's his name?
Ben Affleck.
Ben Affleck is Batman completely
that was bad.
Like deflated me.
Whoever decided to do
and
that.
I'm completely turned off to the fact that freaking vampire sparkly boy is gonna be Batman. You can't do that. Like
you know what? Give him a chance.
Okay, I want
he'll probably be better than
Dilly. I 100% agree with
Ben
you.
Flick.
Okay, I agree with you that one, he will be better than Affleck.
For sure.
Two, I definitely want to give him a chance. But the thing is that with as much as people are like meh, 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 about Spider-Man, I'm like, have a little respect for the character that is Batman. And I don't care how good of an actor you are. if you've been a sparkly vampire in any movie, that completely 100% automatically just means that you can't be Batman.
Okay, hold on.
You've done that movie, you're not allowed to be Batman.
Hold, please, just because I got to be on the other side of the spectrum. Let's all, address the elephant in the room. What about Heath Ledger?
Vampire.
Nobody was on board with him as Joker. Mm-hmm. And he crushed it.
So what? That is true. But what is... What was it that Heath Ledger did that made it so...
What do you mean? Nobody had ever seen a Joker that well, ever.
No, I'm saying, why were people against it? Was it because he did some body of work that people
were
like...
He did Brokeback Mountain
they
before that.
They just didn't expect the performance.
And he had, he's a surfer boy. You look at him like he's got the nice blonde hair. He had done, a bunch of funny movies. He had done Brokeback Mountain that people were not happy about.
Did we mention he did Brokeback Mountain?
Why are people being so homophobes because he did Brokeback Mountain?
I'm just telling you, you look at that and they're, all right, we want you to be this menacing character.
It was the same thing as, it's the vampire guy.
Okay,
they didn't think he could pull it off.
Right. I agree with that. Devil's advocate. I like it, except for that Robert Pattinson was a sparkly vampire in 4 movies. He was so huge as this character. He's known as this character. Heath Ledger was more than anything just kind of
his name
is
Edward.
We don't really know. He's kind of whatever. We're expectations are low.
No, he was a huge star.
The fact what I'm saying is that if you are ever a sparkly vampire, then you are never allowed to be Batman.
Yeah, but look at... All right,
find another actor. How many actors are out there? Just find another one.
I keep going back to this, but Brokeback Mountain was a huge controversy when that came out.
That was an amazing movie.
Yes, but it wasn't it wasn't huge. Everybody was talking about it.
Yeah, but playing a gay cowboy is not playing a sparkly vampire.
I'm just saying it's...
You know what he did with Brokeback Mountain? Really brave and courageous. Playing a sparkly vampire is not.
Well, that is true. It's not very courageous.
He took that part because it was controversial. Okay? He wanted to do that.
So did, his name of being a sparkly vampire?
No, he didn't. He took that because it was, that for one, that's a terrible book. Okay?
I've never read any.
It's a terrible book and it's a terrible movie. And
Michelle's
if you play a sparkly...
Michelle's gonna be so mad.
Okay, but can I tell you something, Michelle, if you're listening?
My wife.
I have read every single one of those books and I've seen every single one of the movies. Okay. So the thing is I actually love them because they're so terrible. But the fact of the matter is that you cannot do that. Okay. I just want it to be a rule in the superhero realm that
if
you're a sparkly vampire.
What if it hits?
If it hits, then I will eat my words.
So you're you're vampire shaming. So anybody that plays a vampire can't. Yeah.
No, it's
they just can't do anything anymore.
No.
So what you're saying is the movie
but you have to
Blade
be sparkly.
Sucks.
Yeah, Blade. Oh, Wesley
have
can't
you guys
do anything
seen
now.
Twilight?
But he wasn't sparkly.
Have you guys
he
seen
wasn't
Twilight?
But there's a difference.
Have you seen Twilight?
Yeah.
That's an embarrassment to vampire movies.
Team Jacob.
Okay, it's an embarrassment to vampire. I love vampires.
Yeah, it was bad.
And you can be a vampire, and then you can be Batman, but you can't be a vampire in the Twilight saga.
A sparkly vampire?
He did sparkle.
Because they sparkle, they can be out in
the
daylight.
Remember that scene he went out and out of the church, he's all sparkly.
He's in the sun.
See, I think it helps that I've never seen
the sun doesn't even hurt him.
You don't have to lie.
It just
I swear I've never watched a single one.
The sun doesn't even hurt him, it just makes him look sparkly. That's
sparkle,
truth,
bro. Straight up.
That's truth. They just live regular lives. They go to regular high school. I can't with this. They're great movies, though. Honestly, I love them.
I like it. You're just trashing. I don't know. We'll wait. See.
I mean, it's like one of those movies.
I just don't know how he's going to fill out the suit.
You guys, I promise
you. He's going to beef up.
I will give you both $10 each.
I heard
he's
going to the
boneyard. If he's a good Batman, you guys both make $10.
Well, I'm not saying he's... I'm the one that's saying give the guy a chance. Because
I
think he's probably going to Heath Ledger you.
No, God, no. That's why I said I'll give you $10 if he's good. Because I guarantee he's not going to be good.
A twomp.
Can your boy get a twomp?
You can get a twomp, buddy.
Okay.
Sheboygan.
Do you think he's going to be good? Because you only get a $20 if you think he's going to be good.
All right. Are we saying better than Affleck or better than Bale?
No, I mean they... Heath Ledger it. Like, he blows you out of the water. He hits.
No, whoa.
Do you think he's going to hit?
That is two different things.
No, he just said he thinks it's going to be a Heath Ledger.
No, because Heath Ledger, that means he's better than Batman of Christian Bale. That will never happen. There is no way ever anybody will ever beat the Christian Bale Batman. Right, Christopher Nolan has changed superheroes for life in those movies will hold the test of time. They're like Star Wars.
Yeah.
The original.
I agree with that.
It is held on such high regard. We're talking about, can he beat Affleck?
No.
Can he be on that
echelon? I'm not giving you $20 because a lot of people can beat Affleck. I mean, there is like a list of 25 people. I could probably be a better Batman.
Hey, do you think he'll be better than Keaton?
No.
Well, nobody's better
Nolan
than Keaton.
Wasn't even better than Keaton.
Nobody's better than Keaton.
Bale wasn't even better
than
Keaton.
What about better than Val Kilmer?
Yeah. He could... do I think this sparkly vampire can be better than him? No.
There's a Twan right there.
I actually think...
There is a Twan right there.
I actually think that... Okay, so if we rank it... You know what we need to do? Okay, I've just decided.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, we need magnets.
No, I've just
some
decided.
Some kind of board or something.
What we're going to do is everybody's going to rank their Batmans.
Are we
going to
do top five Batmans?
And we're going to put... No, we're not going to do that. But we are going to put where we think that Robert Pattinson is going to fall in that line.
I like this. I like this line.
Right. So we'll come back with it.
So give it some time.
And think about it.
And in the Sanctorum... Throw out yours.
Yeah, let us know what your ranking is. Well, one, what your ranking is of Batman and where you think he's going to fall.
If he's going to hit.
Is he going to hit?
Is he going to be a hitter?
He's not. I know he's not going to hit, but he... I just hope he's better than Affleck. That's all.
I'd love to see where people put him.
He's going to be better than Ben
Affleck. He's not going to be good. You guys, have you seen him in... The movie. I've never seen it. He's not even good.
I can't even tell you one movie he's been in that I've watched.
He's not good.
He's Sporkle.
He's fine. But he's no Batman. He is no Batman.
If he blows
this
makes
your
me
so angry.
So good.
I know. And I'd be fine with that because the thing of it is I would love for him to be good. But I just know he's not going to be. Okay, let's move on, you guys. I'm sweating over here.
Yeah, I know.
It's so steamy in the booth.
Okay, so one more thing about Dr. Sleep. We did watch the trailer for Dr. Sleep.
It looks good.
Ewan McGregor. I like Ewan. Buddy, do you think this movie's going to hit? You think it's going to... What do you think? Because they're doing a lot of references to The Shining. They're pulling in a lot of stuff.
I'm not going to lie. Doesn't look that great.
Yeah.
The more I see, it kind of pulls me out of it. The girl that's like...
Oh, the young girl that's kind of like magic.
I'm not huge on girls. Girls.
The young girl.
But like young kids with adults like trying to do that whole back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't know how I'm... But every time I hear the music and I see the Overlook, I get excited.
Can I ask you guys a question?
Because I really love Ewan.
Love Ewan. So the reason I want to ask a question is because I'm not even 100% sure I've seen The Shining all the way through because it's so terrifying.
What?
Oh my God.
I mean, like, I've seen it. I've definitely seen it, but it's so
scary.
One of
the best scary movies of all time.
But it's so scary I'm not 100% sure I've made it all the way through. So my question is this whole, thing he calls The Shining and the magic and the with the glowing eyes.
Okay.
Is that... Any of that in The Shining movie?
Yeah, The Shining is like the power that the boy has.
Yeah.
So the boy's always had this power.
Certain people can kind of like communicate with each other. Okay. They can see hear. They're
but
in tune with
some
other
things. What's
funny
is they never really like named it.
Yeah, they don't go into too much detail really.
No, and that's why he says he's like, I always called it The Shining.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay.
It looks really interesting, and I'm excited, and I want to watch it.
Right.
So I'll definitely go see it. I just feel like the more I watch, you know,
right.
or the more I see of it, the less I'm getting like turned.
Yeah. The thing is like I definitely wonder if it's gonna hit because I really do think they're trying
real
to
quick,
pull
real
too much.
Real quick, she's stealing my sayings. All right, go ahead.
What?
Because I just think that they're trying too hard to put in all these Shining references with the girls and the blood and the door hole where he puts his face through.
Well, my thing is I really hope they go into depth of it, the Overlook close after that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, well, that's over? That's what it says. Yeah, he comes back. It's like closed down. It's kind of run down.
Yeah, are they going to go into it of more of like... Because of that, that's why.
Right.
Mm.
Because before, another family had been killed and it still went on.
Right.
Right.
And so that's what I'm saying is, what was this that sent it over the top?
I almost feel like we might need to watch it just to maybe get that information.
Maybe the body's being chopped in little pieces. I don't know.
So, you guys, I have another question. Sorry. Did, in the book, did anybody read the book?
No.
We know only Nailed a couple of us can read.
All right, that's true. So
definitely not me.
Dilly, did you read it?
I read the movie.
Okay. So basically, I guess I'm...
That was actually really funny.
This is a question to some of our readers, or maybe we could ask one of our brothers because I know he read it. Does anything in this new movie, is that in a book? Or did
Yes, he came it out is based with the on second a book.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you.
The one thing that I'm a little concerned about, like coming back to the Overlook and being back there and all the familiar sights is going to be awesome. But they've kind of worked in like the protagonist in this one.
Right. It
seems to be like some kind of cult that are like harvesting the powers of the Shining.
Right. Yeah.
I think that is what's going to make or break this
movie.
Right,
and that doesn't look great.
And it doesn't. That's what worries me.
Her top hat.
Because in the first one...
Buddy, thank you. Her top hat. I'm like, are you kidding me? She looks like she's like in
exactly.
a ragtag.
Right.
Yeah, it's like that's gang or
that's what's going to ruin the movie, if at all. That's that's what I'm
and
concerned
that's
about.
Where I always get is you're just kind of like, ugh.
Yeah, it's like, oh, man, see, you didn't
do
it right.
And then the glowing in her, the eye. Yeah, I think the whole thing. It seems, that whole part definitely seems
and
a little
And I feel like the girl,
forced.
The little girl is going to be the one to beat everybody.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because something's going to happen to Hewin.
Yeah, and she seems like maybe she's strong. Like, can
she's
there be...
the strongest one, and then Hewin at the very end is going to get hurt or something, and she's going to save everybody. Yeah. Boo.
I think we'll see. It's called Dr. Sleep, which is a weird name, but... So we have some, just some other random news. Star Wars.
Hey, you want to rattle it
off?
Oh,
this is
real
actually
fast.
Funny. We are reading. So a FanX in Salt Lake City, a con in Salt Lake City, Disney actually canceled a panel they were supposed to have with the actor who plays Emperor Palpatine and the guy Hayden Christensen who plays Anakin Skywalker. So they canceled this panel that was supposed to happen. And so it really didn't explain it, but everyone's kind of thinking like the reason they canceled is because
the Rise of Skywalker.
Because of the Rise of Skywalker. So basically they were saying like they're fearing that there's going to be spoilers for Rise of Skywalker. But the thing is they're from episode 1, 2, and 3. So what they're kind of saying by canceling this is Anakin Skywalker in the new movie?
Yeah, because we know the Emperor is, because you hear his laugh.
Right, so...
Andy's in the poster.
So basically it says now everyone thinks that Christensen will be returning as Anakin in the new film.
As probably as a force projection.
Right, so the thing is them canceling this con actually makes it seem like that more than if they were at...
A little bit of leakage.
Yeah, they're almost pushing that thought a little farther. We also have, what else do we have? So, this I actually thought was cool, even though Buddy didn't think it was cool. Jurassic Park has a secret mini movie that's to premiere on FX.
No one cares.
So listen, this sounds really cool. Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom announced Wednesday that they made a secret short film set within the Jurassic universe. And hold on, where's it at? No. Okay, right here. This sounds really good.
Nobody cares.
So Battle at Big Rock is a short film that takes place 1 year after the events of Fallen Kingdom. It's about a family on a camping trip at Big Rock National Park, about 20 miles from where the last film ended. You guys, that
sounds
fun.
You know what it reminds me of? What is that? Is it the third Jurassic Park where that family says that they're super rich because their kid got lost on the island? It's exactly what it reminds me of.
Well, anyway, so then the Jurassic 3 with Chris Pratt and Bryce Dallas Howard is scheduled to be released June 11th, 2021.
I didn't even see the second one.
So the second one was good.
That's a ways out.
So this is just a mini film in between those two movies, which I personally, if you're going to make movies with dinosaurs, I'll watch it. What else we got? Muppets Disney. I guess they were going to do a Muppet show on the Disney Plus channel, but that looks like it got canceled.
Got skriznapped.
Which I'm really upset about. And this line says this was going to be the first series featuring the characters since ABC's failed attempt to launch the scripted mockumentary series, The Muppets, which, in my opinion, was not a failed attempt.
I'm still trying to find it.
Yes, it didn't hit, and maybe it got canceled, but that season was amazing.
I wish they would do it again. The big one that I know you wanted to talk about before we get into some mayo is Patty Jenkins.
Right.
This is big news. Sheila jumped out of her chair when she read about this.
Wait, hold on. Let me see.
So Patty Jenkins has signed a 3-year multiple series deal with Netflix.
So I did freak out because Patty Jenkins actually is the director of Wonder Woman.
Yes.
So,
and Monster.
And this is something that's just so depressing to me. Okay. Even though it's amazing, but it's depressing that it's taken so long. So Wonder Woman is the first female directed film with a budget over $100 million. 2019. It's the first time. It's the first time a big budget movie of over $100 million has been directed by a female. What is happening?
She's breaking down doors.
It's the year of the female.
So anyway, I'm really excited for Patty Jenkins. So she's got a 3-year multi-series deal with Netflix. Yeah, she's doing it. She's coming
she's
up, Patty.
Paid.
What's
good
up, Patty?
She's getting that money.
So I'm really excited to see what she comes out with.
I'm super excited because Monster and Wonder Woman obviously are super amazing. So I think it's going to be great. So Wonder Woman 1984 is set to hit theaters June 5th, 2020. So
that
it's the next.
Fun.
It's coming up. I think that's going
to
be
back,
cool.
Like a throwback to the Linda Carter days.
Mm-hmm. Right. So that's
Sidekick Mayo.
So what do we
Sorry, was that
a little yeah, I mean, you cut me off, but that's fine.
No, I was actually okay with it.
I definitely tend
but
to
But it was kicking me under the table.
Yeah. She's a big old bag of boar over there.
Okay, so we
talking about Jurassic World.
Sidekick Mayo.
So, I'm
big old bag of boar.
I'm going to read this first email.
Real quick. Bag of boys.
So this is from Louie.
Out of Louie.
Louie. You know what's funny, Louie? Can I tell you something?
A tutti frutti. Old Rudy.
Tutti frutti.
Old Rudy.
So, tutti frutti. Louie, I want to tell you something.
Good falsetto right
Can
there.
I tell Louie something?
That was good.
Can I? Real quick?
Can what? I finish?
Can I finish? What? Can I finish? So
what? Yeah.
Real quick.
What?
All right, go ahead.
So my middle name is Louise, which was passed down from my mother. And I had a friend who, my friend Jovi, remember Jovi?
Yeah.
She, when we worked at Borders for a long time together, she always called me Louie. That was my my nickname. I really actually always wanted that to catch on. I think I'm going to start.
How many nicknames do you want to catch on?
I think I'm going to start calling myself Louie.
No. Oh my God.
Louie, Tater Tots, Push and Mush.
Yeah, I didn't want that one to stick. Okay, so email from Louie. Finally, with the group all together, the magic is happening again. Are you planning another event soon in the movie theater for fans? I hope it is in the works as those events are very awesome. You can always count on the Hardly Heroes crew for fun, laughter, updates, and crazy, ever-growing length nicknames. Louie. That's actually funny because I didn't reread this. It's funny that I just added another nickname on.
Louie.
Thanks, Louie. Thanks for writing in. We always enjoy it.
Yeah, we do like giving people nicknames. It's kind of our favorite thing. Yeah.
Okay, do we have any more?
Sidekick Mayo!
We do.
Okay, should I read this one?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is from Katana. Is that right? We've heard from Katana
before.
Yeah,
we heard from Katana last week.
Mortal Kombat.
Katana.
Yeah.
Okay. Very cute. All right. Wow.
That's cute.
Thanks for reading my letter. Your show was funny and I enjoyed listening in during my work shift. I get so busy, it was nice to have a laugh. Buddy may act like he's unaware and unaware of his arch nemesis. Don't let him fool you. He doesn't want to admit that he's there's a better, younger, funnier, wittier, smarter, more attractive, and better aging version of himself in existence in his little world. Also, Shmee is clearly the better sibling.
Yep.
And my favorite on the show.
Woo!
She's not Cheese Whiz. She's top of the line Gouda, at least.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hashtag Katana. Hashtag better than Buddy. Hashtag Sarah Connor. Hashtag winning. Hashtag guess who.
Buddy, do you know who it is?
So I didn't know if this was going to come out. So there has been this new person that started at my work named Sarah.
Sarah.
And so Sarah wanted to write into the show and she's like, I want to come up with this whole persona and do my own thing. And I was like, all right, cool, dude. I was like, that'd be awesome. I was like, we love when people write in, make up these characters and everything. So we fight like siblings. We always make fun of each other. I mean, obviously, she's not as great as me. I'm a radio icon sensation.
Yeah, but obviously, I'm better than you. So
no. So
hashtag
she
better sibling.
Writes in. She's like, oh, I'm going to write in. And I didn't know what her email said. And she called herself the GOAT. And I was like, that was a dumb move. And she's like, what do you mean? I'm like, there's a goat on the show? You can't just write in and not listen to the show and not know what you're talking about. So that was pretty funny. So she got a lot of flack for that. But she thinks she's better than me. She's not. She's actually in Killeen, Texas right now.
Oh, really? Is she going through the training?
Yeah, doing the class that I did. And the worst part is she's been doing the job I'm doing for 8 months.
Oh.
And so now you got to go to the training?
She's like breezing
through.
Hopefully
you hooked her up with like some cliff notes and
stuff. Oh, I gave her everything. So if she passes, it's because of me.
There you go. Good looking out.
Well, Sheboygan thank you.
Nice to hear from you, Katana.
Yeah, thank you, Katana, a.k.a. Sarah, a.k.a. Better Buddy, for
a.k.a.
writing in.
The worst coworker of all time. And that's above Tamis from the Boneyard.
I hope that she has a better roommate than you did.
Yeah, my roommate was weak sauce.
Brent, what was his name?
Brett.
Okay.
Brett.
So we have another email, and it's actually the name.
Shout out. I miss you, Charlos.
The name of the email is in capital letters, correction. Okay.
Oh, correction.
I just listened to the current episode.
Oh.
Okay, wait. I'm sorry. Real quick. This is from Casey. I just listened to the current episode, and you guys said I never wrote into a firm cheese's story about the fact that I got recognized by Casey at Rite Aid. I did, in fact, write in that very next day from the episode where you mentioned it, but I wrote on the Facebook page and not email. Someone even replied. Scroll through that, please, and see that I did confirm the story. Your neighborhood Rite Aid manager and friend, Casey Scott. So what's funny is...
There you go, Casey.
I actually emailed Casey back, and I'm like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. I can't believe that, you know, maybe we didn't see it. And then I went into Rite Aid the other day to get some crackers.
Uh-huh.
Because Logan went to the store, got cheese, salami.
But no crackers?
No crackers.
What?
So he was giving me crack because I didn't say thank you for the cheese and salami. I just said, where's the crackers?
Well, I mean, you can't eat it without the crackers.
So anyway, I went to Rite Aid looking real tore up.
Like always.
And I got some crackers and I also got some Cheez-Its. And Casey was there. And I'm like, dang it, Casey.
We're going to have to go see Casey one of these nights.
The only reason why Casey says he recognizes her is because Sheila buys so much stuff there that, you know, he feels obligated.
This is like a payoff type of situation.
That's what I'm saying. And I still don't know if it really is Casey or if it's not Sheila that she's writing in for him.
How would I know Casey's last name?
We might have to trace this email back a little bit, a little further.
We're going to have to look some IP addresses here.
I do want to real quick. There's another thing. Johnny wrote in. It's just a quick email, but remember last week he said.
Hold on. Shout out real fast to Casey. Your request has been noted. So make sure you listen all the way to the end of Hardly Heroes.
Hashtag secret track.
Yeah.
Shout out, Mammy.
Especially for you.
Yeah. Yep. We talked to Mam and she said, you know what? What Casey wants? Casey gets.
Yeah, she's right. All sidekicks, ask, and they shall receive. Mm-hmm. The hymnals.
sorry, I totally forgot that. So, real quick, Johnny did write in. He said, as promised, Johnny. My dear friends, I'm sending you a copy of the beginning of Dark Heroine's background snap. Story.
Heck yeah. Heck
so, that
yeah.
short story that he wrote, what? He sent that via email. So, all right. Really, what I think maybe I'll do is ask Parm to print it out so we can all read it.
Yeah.
My English translation is a bit limited, but I think you'll understand it. Love the last episode. It was so great that Jay Jackal is back and Sunny is in it for the big leagues.
I do like that.
Yes, you are always my number one podcast, because remember.
Yeah, I would have killed you. Come on now. I flew to Norway. I would have broke your ankles again.
Thanks to Sunny for sharing this awesome ride of a fun experience. I have been on for over a year now, more than 100 episodes. Well, it's time to say goodbye. Oh, yeah. Keep up the good work. My short story is attached to this email. Just remember, this is not the final cut in the story. Sweet. I'm rewriting things. Cool. So your friend, a.k.a. Johnny Norwegian Titan. Johnny, thank you so much for sending that. Yeah. We're going to read it, and then maybe we'll talk about it.
Come back next episode, week. And we'll
take a gandy.
Tell you about what we thought.
Oh, so man. That's our sidekick, Mayo.
Mayo.
Yeah.
But oh my God, you guys, I need real to quick? Stop saying real quick. That's real annoying.
It's your crutch word.
Yeah, that's going to get annoying. Like, I don't have to say that every time I want to talk.
Just talk.
Okay. Just say something. say something.
Straight say up something, now, tell me, do you really want to love?
Me forever.
Jay Jackal.
In my car, in a hit and run.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jay Jackal, that's for you. For one, Jay Jackal, you know you love my singing. Okay.
Jackal Thoughts with Jay Jackal.
So we do need to pump a few things, boys.
Pump.
Before
pump.
We go.
I said pump. Pump. Pump, pump it up.
Pump
that Titan Spirit up.
Pump.
So
I like
this
that.
Weekend, actually... In 2 days,
pop, lock, and drop it.
We're going to be at California Republic Comic Con in Merced, California with Woo! Colossus Girl Entertainment. And our favorite organization will be their Project Wish Upon a Star.
Yeah, buddy.
And our good pals, Darren and Veronica, who run the organization, will be there. And there is rumor. I'm not 100% sure this has completely been dropped. I don't know if it's been announced on social media.
It's on the line. Not.
But Buddy, it's rumor.
A.K.A. Buddy, the Mad King, A.K.A. the pop culture sensation radio icon himself.
Is rumored to be maybe getting into a hot dog costume.
Yes.
Yay!
Taking pictures, you know, drumming up donations to get people to eat delicious hot dogs.
Nathan's hot dogs. And please... Yay! Yeah, and it's for Project Wish Upon a Star, which we always are down. Buddy's always down.
The scariest part is my wife wants to fight me to wear the costume.
She wants it?
She wants to wear it bad.
That's actually pretty funny.
And she'll probably be the first in line because she loves hot dogs.
Mm.
Especially Nathan's. They're delicious.
Yeah, they're actually delicious.
Are they kosher, I believe?
I think so.
Kosher K?
But we will be posting a picture that...
So are we allowed to post that? I'll have to ask Veronica.
Yeah, I wouldn't...
Has it been dropped? Yeah. Okay. So we'll post some pictures, but some of the guests and the panels that actually Hardly Heroes will be facilitating...
Hosting.
...is Eddie Deason from Grease, Invalid Delia, who played Princess Leia in Rogue One. We have the Land of the Lost reunion panel.
That's
actually...
Cool.
Pretty cool. That's going to be a big deal. Project Wish Upon a Star, of course, will have a booth and a hot dog stand.
Yum.
And then, of course, we will have the Hardly Heroes table, which I believe the lovely Alex Scalardo. What do we call her? Mrs.
Scalardo?
Skillard. Okay, Mrs. Skillard. Okay.
I like Mrs. Skillard.
So Mrs. Skillard and the Mad Queen herself, Michelle, will be at the Hardly Heroes table selling... Birdie and Bean bags, which, you know, half of the 50% of the proceeds go to Project Wish Upon a Star. We'll have, you know, just, I don't know what else we're going to have at the booth. Let me see. Swag, bags, say hi, take pics. So just stop by if you're there. Come to our table.
Just stop by real quick.
Yeah.
Real quick.
Real quick.
So we also, again, so the following weekend, Hardly Heroes will be at Wizard World Sacramento.
Sacramento.
Now, this is a big deal, you guys. It's going to be September 20th through the 22nd. The guest list is Jason Momoa. We have Holly Marie Combs from Charmed and Pretty Little Liars. We have Brian Krause from Charmed. Drew Fuller from Charmed. I guess it's kind of like a big Charmed thing.
Big Charmed.
We have Lori Petty, who was Tank Girl.
Oh, that's cool, awesome.
Right? And she's in Orange is the New Black, but Tank Girl is like definitely like what I remember her from.
Yeah.
And there also are some other guests. So the thing is that we will be there. We have press passes. We don't necessarily have a booth, but we may be, and this is rumor.
This is rumor right
this
now.
This is rumor. Nothing has been decided, but we may be doing a live podcast from Wizard World. And we also may be having a Jerry Mulaney, who is the production. What is it called?
He's the actual.
What is it? The event promoter. Yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. He's the event promoter for Wizard World. So he actually may. That's a rumor. Also, may be on our show next week.
We're gonna try to get him on. He does have a huge event going on, so hopefully he can make it. We'll
exactly.
See.
Yeah. He's coming in. He's flying in on Thursday, so we know if he does show up. You know, we'll be really thankful for him coming in. But,
right. And if he doesn't make it, of course, we understand.
Yeah, because he's got the event the next day. But we are going to be there.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
So come hang out. Let us know if you're going to be there and we'll meet up.
Yeah, please let us know. And then also just another real quick shout out. Please, please, please sign up for that 5K run.
Yes.
It's thesuperrun.com. When you sign up, search Team Hardly Heroes, password Sidekicks.
Yeah, or come out to Merced and come hang out with us.
Let's do it, peeps, Sidekicks. Let's just congregate. Let's hang out.
Yeah.
Where do they be finding us at, though?
They can find us on YouTube at Hardly Heroes. They can find us on Facebook at Hardly Heroes.
Where else?
They can find us on Instagram at Hardly Heroes.
And then?
They can find us on Twitter at Hardly Heroes.
Okay.
Number one.
You can also find us at our online Facebook forum. It's the Hardly Heroes Sidekick Sanctorum.
And you can just go to hardlyheroes.com, email us straight from there.
The website, or you can email us at hardlyheroes@gmail.com.
And just remember one thing.
Disclaimer, they don't know sh**.
You guys have a good night.
Have a good night, y'all.
Bye, love you.
I looked out the window and what did I see? Popcorn popping on the apricot tree. Spring has brought me such a nice surprise. Blossoms popping right before my eyes. I could take an armful and make a treat. A popcorn ball that would smell so sweet. It wasn't really so bad, it seemed to me. Popcorn popping on the apricot tree.